Hey Galacticans, this is Samantha coming to you on Saturday for Training Star Galactica, and this week the topic is set by me, and my question is, what is it you love about being trans? And so in case you didn't notice, I'm rocking the red hair today, and I went and got my hair done last weekend, which is something that I never had done before I transitioned. So, that's just kind of one example of things that I love about being trans, just being able to go get my hair done, do something girly, something that I was sort of afraid to do before, and I'm not anymore, and it makes me feel good. So, of course, I'm going to do it. And I love that I've come to that sort of understanding, you know, to understand that it's okay to like girly things if I was born a boy. And I love to kind of just wallow in that, just all the things that I am free to do now that I've come to terms with my transsexualism or my transgender. And there are so many things that I feel I've earned along the last 2.5 years of my journey. I've gained so much understanding about myself. I've sort of developed some minor ability to look inside myself and examine things in a way I never could before. So that kind of ties into, you know, just small tangent. Before I transitioned, I was in this place where I just didn't want to face. I didn't want to dissect anything. I didn't want to examine my feelings about things, for reasons I won't go into. But now that I've transitioned, I feel like I'm frequently looking within myself and dissecting, what am I feeling? Why am I feeling this? You know, what is it that I want? And what is making me happy? What is making me unhappy? You know, I'm able to look at my friendships and my relationships in a completely new way. Because I feel like the friendships that I've kept with people that knew me as Samuel, I feel like those are the people that I know are kind of the good ones, you know? And I feel really lucky in that I've really been able to keep a lot of friends. And just, you know, just that I can tell people in my life about my gender, and they can, and they are saying, you know, good for you, and this is great for you, and we see how much happier you are, and just knowing that, having that reinforcement, I just really love it, and, you know, I guess that that's very location-based, a very location-centric privilege, to have acceptance by those around you. And I know that there are a lot of places in the world where this changing gender, or other variants of gender or variants of sexuality are punishable by death. And I think that really disturbs me. And I hope that we can, I don't know what we can do about it, I have to be honest, but I hope that the people that are being so oppressive in this regard someday will change their minds and realize how foolish they're being. Because trans people are amazing. People all, you know, people that are all colors of the rainbow are amazing. And I don't know, I'm happy to be part of that. I'm happy to be part of that LGBT community. LGBTQ, and any other letters I don't remember. You know who you are, if you know if you belong in that group or not. And I mean, I really take a lot of pride in that. I guess I should also say that this weekend is Pride in San Francisco. I better not be wrong about that, otherwise I'm in big trouble. But, you know, just, I've been thinking a lot about Pride lately because I have a lot of pride for myself and for my transition and my journey and the struggles that I've been through and overcome. And I've never been to a Pride celebration before. Actually, it's really funny because last year, another small tangent, in 2009, I was in Copenhagen during Seattle Pride, but then I was in Seattle during Copenhagen Pride. So I missed two prides. So I'm trying to make up for it this year by going to three prides. And I really intend to wave my flags strong and hard, because I'm just proud of myself. And that's... I've never really felt this way before I transitioned. I've always felt kind of timid, kind of like, oh, what do people think of me, and am I doing something dumb, or, you know, why is everyone cooler than I am, or something like that, you know. I was so comparative when it came to myself. And now I just know that I'm unique in my own way, and everybody is, and I take pride in the ways that I am unique, and I guess I mean both my, you know, including my flaws. I think that my flaws actually kind of make me so likable. Like my big nose. But, that's really funny. So what else do I love about being trans? I love my trans friends. I love being part of the trans community, specifically, connecting with other trans people, because we have all been on this different journey. We have kind of faced things in ourselves and kind of reached within to bring something new out into the world, and, you know, dealt with the way the world has received that in whatever way we've had to. And I think that trans people are some of the most brilliant people in the world. I think that, you know, the trans people that I've met are the most creative and intelligent people. I mean, what else can I say? Everything would be kind of an offshoot of that, I guess. Intelligent and creative. And just, they're just such good people. I found that I just have so much in common with so many of them. Not with everybody, but, I think that we're just a good group. I think that we're a really good group, and I think that the next revolution is going to be the trans revolution. And, I'm excited to live in this time. I'm excited to be trans in this time. I still wish that I lived in this time where you could just take the gender change pill, or the sex change pill, or whichever word is most appropriate. But life is what it is, and we deal with the cards we're dealt. And I guess that's how I want to close out, is by saying that being trans has helped me play the best hand that I can in life, with the cards that I've been dealt, and the cards that get dealt to me on a daily basis. So, I will leave you with that. I hope you're having a great weekend and a great Saturday, and you're at peace with life and yourself and the world. And I'll see you next week.